Hello guys, your boy Footgrinch here. Today I'm gonna share with you how to use Barcelona. My friend Hasib, he has a YouTube channel, I'll link it down below, explain to me how to use this. And I have a post on Instagram, but I wanted to explain to everyone why we pick these players. First thing that I wanna tell you is, who is this video for? Well, this video is for you. This video is for you only if you are struggling to win games against your friends, or you're struggling to win games on seasons online. If you're not struggling, then I wouldn't watch this, because if you're already good at the game, why are you watching this? But if you want to continue winning games against your friends and you don't want them to watch my video and then start beating you, and you want to be on the upper hand, then stay, you know? I will make sure to at least give you one or two laughs along the video, and then I will also explain why I picked, well, why Hasid picked each of these players, right? First of all, Ter Stegen, you don't have a better goalkeeper on Barcelona. You actually don't have a better goalkeeper on the game. Right back, we have Semedo, because actually we don't have another right back on this team. We have Sergio Roberto, but as you can see, his pace is lacking. Umtiti, I prefer Umtiti. Hasib prefers Piqué. I prefer Umtiti because of the 68 pace. Piqué has 56, and I mean, on online it doesn't matter that much, but I am bad at defending and I need my player to be able to run when they pass me, so I prefer Umtiti. We have Lenglet, Alba. For these two, there are no more options. Like, come on, are you gonna use Firpo really as your left back? We have Vidal, and this is one where you could go with different cards, but I prefer Vidal over Arthur, or over Busquets, or over Rakitic, because of the pace. I mean, he doesn't have better pace than Arthur, but he's way better, way, way, way better at defending and physicality. And your midfield, your couple of midfielders, are the most important part of your team. They literally are the heart of it. So you need a good couple. And as you can see, because Vidal has a high, he will stay defending, he will stay in the middle. And De Jong, being a high medium, he will also stay, and sometimes he will go up. One of them will go up, not both at the same time. That's why we will also use, I'll share it later on the instructions. De Jong, as you can see, is taller. Oh, actually, they are both the same size. Well, I don't think they are the same size. If you go and check on Footbin, I'm sure De Jong is a bit taller than Vidal. But I don't know how those, like, 5'11 works. Then our cam will be Messi. And I mean, yeah, you could be asking yourself, why is he using Messi as a cam? Is he crazy? Why doesn't he use Messi as his right winger? Because Griezmann, right, with his pace, in his passing, on online, he's not that bad as a winger. If you're playing for Champions, okay, it makes sense to have a 90 pace winger. But here, people cannot apply shadow to the right backs and left backs and center backs. And there are center backs oftentimes around 60 to 70 something pace. So 81 is actually enough to beat most right backs. You want Messi as your cam because he is the best player in your team. And who wouldn't like all the balls going through the best player on your team? Do you only want your player to be left on a wing? No, man. He's way better as a cam. We have Dembele. Yes, I'm changing his position. Normally he plays on the right wing. I'm using him as a left winger because he has 5-star weak foot and 5-star skill move. And Griezmann only has 3 weak foot. So in this case, Griezmann, if he goes from the right, he can score with his left foot because he's whack with his right one. Oh, basically. Suarez. We don't have another option. Barcelona hasn't taking the time to buy another striker, so we can't. I mean, if I could have a striker with over 80 pace, I would use a striker with over 80 pace, but again, Suarez, 73 pace should be decent enough online rather than Foot Champions. You know, if you're in Foot Champions, please do not get Suarez, please. Now, your changes. What players to bring in? If you're winning the game, right, the best player to bring in my personal opinion, is to bring Vidal back. Well, take Vidal out and bring either Busquets or Arthur. Or if you think you're going to lack on defense, you can take De Jong out and bring Busquets or Arthur. And yes, a lot of people will go on to say that Busquets is too slow, but yet again, you're playing online. Not everyone is really pacey, and you're bringing the players on the 60th, between the 60th and 70th minute. So most of the opposing team players are already tired. So Busquets will be able to catch up. Plus, him being really tall, that would be a great addition because all your players are small. Like Messi's small, Griezmann is small, Dembele is not the tallest. Not even Suarez is really tall. Your midfield is okay, cool. And then you have your center backs. So Suarez is not going to go back to defend, is he? So you need a bit of height on the midfield. But yet again, if you don't like his pace, just have Arthur. If you're losing, that's different. If you're losing, I wouldn't bring a defensive player in. I would try and bring a complete player, like someone that can pass, shoot, and defend. And then I'll bring someone that's really good at shooting and attacking. So I personally like Rakitic for the young, and I personally like Arthur for Vidal, or Roberto, Sergio Roberto for Vidal. Even though he's 82 here, I think he's 80 here. I think he's like 82 rated, and he looks decent for the midfield. I mean, I think he's weak. Yeah, he has 4 skill moves and 3 weak fits, so he looks really, really good. Really, really good, guys. Awesome. So I covered all of that. If you're crazy enough and you like Ansu Fati, I think he has 5-star skill move. Maybe, I don't know. Yeah, he's a 4-4. He has decent pace. You can bring him on. He won't score a single chance. Well, actually, he has 71 finishing, so he may score one or two chances. But now with the instructions, that's something that I think same instructions work for most people. So I would tell you how this team will behave, because that's basically what instruction does. They tell your players how to behave. Now, you won't do anything on Ter Stegen. You won't do anything on your center backs. Your right back, you will have them on step back while attacking both, and then everything else will be the same. Why are you doing this? Because these players will often try and go up, and you want them to be on the back, waiting for that counter attack to get the ball back and then give it back to Vidal or De Jong, and then you can start your own counter attack or you can start your own play. You don't want them going up, and then you having like a right winger there that Umtiti has to catch up to. Your midfielders will have cover center and stay back while attacking on both. If you want, you can leave De Jong unbalanced or bring him, get him on get forward or something if you want him to, get a bit more involved. And if you're having trouble passing the ball on the midfield or getting the ball to your attackers, you can tell De Jong to like go up. It's easy. You just have to put get forward. You can change it in game. Cover center because we don't want them going crazy and covering the wing and then leaving the middle with nothing there, because you are already your right back, your full backs are already on a stay back while attacking, so they won't have to necessarily cover the wing, so they can stay in the center. Now, your wingers, they are both on default because we don't need them to stay forward or anything. They will already, I think both have high attacking work rates, so they will stay up. Our friend Messi just put stay forward. Messi knows what to do on the game already, and there is not much more that you could do to him so that he becomes a better card. Get forward will be good enough so that he will always be close to Suarez, so they can do like a 1-2, and then you can score with Messi or make a nasty pass to Suarez and he can score. Suarez will have stay central, and he will be your target man because all the balls are gonna go to him. Him being a decently physical player, you'll be able to get the ball down when you pass it to him and then give it to Messi, Griezmann, or Dembele, and you'll be able to score a lot of goals this way. But yeah, guys, that's everything for today. Thank you so much for watching. And yeah, if you see my record and you see Division 9, it's because my brother plays on this account. And he sucks, like literally. I played one game and I won it, and then he played 5 games. He lost 3 and won 2 on Division 10. Imagine that. But well, thank you so much for being a part of this family. I really appreciate you all being here. I will leave a link down below to my Instagram profile, to one post that simplifies all of this and just puts in puts it on one, but I think you guys wanted to understand why we picked some players. So thanks to Hasib on that. See you in the next time.